I love the sea trout because you can catch so many and huge fish. You have to experience how the fish live and how fish feeding.
I think there's something about those fish that they can grow so big alongside the Danish coastlines and the colors and everything. The whole hunt for those fish is just amazing.
I think our strategy is to cover as much water as possible. Some rough weather and it's gonna be tough, but I think we can do it.
Yeah, there's a follower, Erik. There's a follower.
Another one.
Yeah.
Oh! Come on.
Whoa.
Come on, Erik.
Yeah!
Oh, oh damn it!
Yeah, nice match. Ah!
See it. Yes! Oh my god, it's a beautiful
fish. Don't lose
Fuck.
It!
Sick, that was a lure. Erik, did you tie this knot?
Oh yeah!
Yes!
Nice!
For a very long time, we have dreamed about making a YouTube fishing competition targeting sea trout. And now is the time. Welcome to Sea Trout Smash Season 1. In this very first season, we have teamed up with Savage Gear and have two teams battling each other at some of the very best sea trout destinations here in Denmark.
Our first choice was to shoot the entire competition in the spring of 2020. But due to the coronavirus, we had to reschedule and film the whole competition in the autumn instead. Because of that, the teams are gonna face some really hard conditions as the autumn trout can be really tricky to catch. Furthermore, we had to think out of the box and we came up with a brand new point system just for the first season of Sea Trout Smash.
As in many other competitions, it's all about having the most points. But the thing is that all the lures the teams are gonna be using is gonna cost them some points they have earned from catching fish. Each team starts day one with 200 points and no lures. Here they have to be smart and buy the lures they think they're gonna use during the day.
At the start of the following days, we are gonna take away all the lures they have bought and they have to buy new ones. The cost of a lure is 20 points in the morning before they start fishing. If they want to buy new lures at the water, the price increases with 10 points. Every time a team catches a fish above 30 centimeters, points are given. And as you can see here, a big fish can deliver a lot of important points. That's about it with the rules. Now it's time to let the competition begin. Let's head over to Søren and Erik, who is now choosing their first lures of Sea Trout Smash Season 1. Good luck, guys.
All right, Erik, start of day one, start of the competition.
Yeah.
We have to choose some lures.
And tippet.
And tippet, of course.
Yeah, we can choose between 0.35 and 0.30.
Yeah, let's take the 30.
Yeah.
Okay, that's 10 point. Then we talked about getting some, like two lures each.
Yeah, that's good.
Yeah,
sounds good.
So a sand eel, of course. Maybe two sand eels and two swirlings.
Yeah, I would like to choose the 15 gram sand eel first.
Yeah, for sure, for sure.
And I really, really like the motor oil color.
Yeah, that's a classic.
Ah, that's nice.
Yeah, because that works both in like clear water and murky water.
And with a red dot, it's perfect.
Yeah, it's nice. And then I think I would like to choose a swirling. And how about if we choose it in the smallest version and the medium version? So we have a 12 gram and a 16 gram.
Yeah, that sounds really nice.
It should be enough.
Makes sense.
So the smallest one, what color do you think?
I would like to take a really
the natural one.
Yeah.
Like a sand eel color.
So good, yeah.
Okay, so that's one of them.
Yeah.
And then we should have a medium swirling as well.
Maybe the motor oil, actually.
Yeah, again, yeah, why not?
It's a bit cloudy today and it's a bit shiny, so it should work. Yeah.
Okay, so the 19 gram sand eel. Which color do you think? We have the motor oil now. Should we pick something with a bit of color?
Yeah, for sure.
Okay,
Yeah.
We're gonna try the black cover then. I feel it's okay with 110 points left because, yeah, of course the points are getting transferred to next day. So if we don't catch a fish, we'll start tomorrow with 110 points.
That's enough.
Okay. Yeah, it should be enough, but we're gonna catch a fish.
Definitely.
Ready for this?
Yeah.
Let's do it.
Okay, an exciting choice by Søren Erik, who ended up buying tippet and four lures. That had a cost of 90 points in total and leave them with 110 points left. Let's see what Mats and Lasse are up to.
So, what do you think we should look at, Mats? For sand eels first?
Yes.
Let's find the right sizes. Eels.
Yeah.
Okay. 11 grams. I mean, this is the beginning of September. It can be really, really deadly right now, but I think we should go up in size. The water temperature is still really high, so I think we should go search for some open coast.
Yeah, deeper water.
Deeper water, close to the shoreline. So I think we're gonna pack them away from now. 19 grams, now we're talking. Okay, Matze.
You think it's okay? 19 grams, okay. Yeah.
Yes. It is beginning of September. Yeah. So we can catch the fish on both natural colors and Yeah.
Short colors.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. So I think if you're going with the little bit brighter colors,
red and black,
it's really black, can be really, really good on this time of year. Okay. I think I'm gonna go with a 15 gram version.
Yeah. Take a 50 gram.
So we get so much variation in our fishing.
Yeah.
Now we have yours with the red and black to irritate the fish, maybe to bite. But I will go more natural.
Okay.
This is my favorite, the matte white topies. And we have 200 points, and each lure is 20 points, and they will increase with 10 points if we have to buy lures when we're out on the water. So we have to be smart here. This is a competition about having most points to win, so we don't want to spend all our points now if the fishing gets rough. This is the brand new LC Serling. Very interesting lure right now. I think this is a good choice.
Okay, I will try it.
Okay?
Yeah.
So 16 grand. Serling for you and a 19 gram sand eel. I'm downsizing a little bit today, I can feel. So I think I'll be looking for a seeker right now. If the fish are tricky to catch, small lures can really, really be effective. So I think I'm gonna go with a natural one and this one. Mm-hmm. So are we set?
Yeah.
Let's do it.
With Matze and Lasse buying 4 lures of 20 points each and some leader material for 10 points, they have also used 90 points. Hopefully these lures will bring them a lot of points today. While both teams are getting ready for this very first day of the competition, let's have a look on today's fishing water. The first 2 days is gonna go down on the Danish sea trout island, Fyn. This place is known for many good things, but especially the many and from time to time really huge sea trout. Many sea trout anglers from in and out of country are traveling here to reach some of the very best spots we have in Denmark. Both teams are starting out the same place and is free to drive wherever they want as long as they stay on the island. Let's head back to the teams who are now rolling out to their first spot and see if they can manage to catch some sea trout on the first day of Sea Trout Smash.
Alright, Erik, so time to go to the first spot?
Yeah, I'm super excited.
Yeah, I think it's gonna be awesome, and I think it's a good choice to go to the less windy side.
Yeah.
And if the fish doesn't want to bite there, or maybe if we get a lot of followers following in, we can always consider going to like a bit more wavy water.
Milky water, search for milky water maybe.
Yeah, yeah. But it's always like a gamble, a big gamble.
Yeah.
So we gotta find the fish,
yeah.
And the fish gotta bite. But I think if we find them, we should be able to either feel them or see them.
Yeah, and we have lots of time.
Oh, that's some of the other guys going there.
Nice.
And they're going the other way.
Yeah.
Oh.
Okay, now we are on our way to the first spot. It's deeper water, close to the shoreline. On one side, we will have the wind coming a little bit in, so we can try fish on more rough weather and waves and stuff. But on the outside, we have the wind in our back. That maybe can help us drag the hotter surface water out, so we get the colder water from the deeper areas coming in and cool the water temperature a little bit down. There is no excuse right now for not catching anything. We should catch some fish today.
Now that sounds very much like a plan to me. Well, if you manage to find the fish at the first location, you can have a great start on the competition. Now, let's head back to Søren and Erik, who has now rolled up on the first spot of the day.
So we just rolled up on the very first spot. We have a bit of a walk down to the water. It's not that far, but it looks quite nice. It's not dead flat surface down there anyway, so we got a bit of like obstruction in the water. And the wind is coming like perfectly from behind us, so I think it will be good.
We have to maybe try it 30 minutes.
Yeah.
And if there's nothing, or maybe maximum 45 minutes,
yeah.
The time is running, then we have to.
Yeah, time is actually really running.
Yeah.
I think it's important just to cover some water down there.
Yeah.
But I think let's go down there, have a look at the water.
Casting, and running.
And make a plan down there maybe.
Yeah.
So we're gonna be effective. Really like the shallow water now. We have to wait out a bit. But yeah, we were pretty optimistic still. So the first thing we're choosing is
sand eel, 15 gram.
You're fishing the sand eel, 15 gram.
And motor oil, yeah.
And I'll be using actually the motor oil as well, but just in the serling in a 60 gram. If the fish is here, we should see them or at least feel them.
Yeah.
Or maybe get some followers or something. So yeah, that's quite the tactic now. I have rigged it up on the fluorocarbon leader with 2 small beads on it and then a medium-sized treble hook at the end.
Here a lot of small bait fish. So, and I can't see a shrimp.
There's a lot of small gobies.
Yeah, I think
they're swimming all over.
Yeah, I think
that can both be a good and a bad thing.
If you can see those small vegetation tops out there, we're just going to wait out there very slowly and start the fishing out there. The water is really shallow in here, but the fish can go all the way in here, for example.
And today we have also low water conditions.
Yeah. As
maybe
you can
half.
See on the beach, yeah. It's really, really shallow now.
40 centimeters less than normal.
Yeah.
I think.
So let's go out there and take the first couple of casts.
Well, I don't know what you think, but to me, these conditions seem quite difficult. I surely hope there are some fish around, despite the flat water. With Søren and Erik already fishing at their first spot, Les and Matze have decided to drive to the more northern part of Fyn in the hunt for some point fish. Here, they arrive 20 minutes later than Søren and Erik and is now getting ready to hit the water.
Okay, we arrived to the spot here now. There was a little problem when we got here because there was already other fishermen, and we talked to them and they said they would only be here for 20 minutes, so we just let them fish first. Always remember to respect each other when you're out on the coast. I'm going with the 15 gram sand eel in the matte white color as we bought from home, and you are starting out with the serling 16 gram in the copper, and the other guys are gone now, so we will start fishing. It's a little bit later than what the plan was, but that's something we live with, and you ready?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Let's give it a try.
So I just changed to the 19 gram sand eel because the serling I went for before, it's going a bit too deep here. The weeds here are just like really close to the surface. So I think this one can go a bit higher in the water. So the main thing we're doing right now when we are walking and fishing is actually just to cover some water, because right now we don't know where the fish are. They could be everywhere here. We have some deeper water out here. We are like walking on a big flat here, all the way down there of sand. And then we got some deeper water out there and some deeper water in here. So we're actually surrounded by deep water. So it's really important for us to cover some water and just try to fish those small darker spots with vegetation, and hopefully there will be a sea trout somewhere around them. Don't you agree?
Yeah, and I think we don't have to cast every single meter because the water is so clear here. The fish come minimum at 5 meters and grab the lure.
They can see it from
a
long distance.
In this shallow water. So we have to go really fast and do lots of casts.
So my plan right now is to cover as much water as possible in all directions. I'm never casting the same direction all the time unless I see a fish or I have a follower. But right now I just made a cast further out, straight out in front of me. And my next cast would be maybe to a little bit to the right or all around to the left here. It's really important that you cover as much water as possible because the fish have a tendency to go in schools right now. So if you find a fish now, that you can almost be sure that there's more fish out there. So right now it's just all about finding the fish and see if we can get them to take our lures.
Hey.
It's a small one, but it's a fish. It's the first of the day. I'm just gonna take this one fast.
Whoops. Nice, Lasse. First fish.
First fish of the day. I just made a short cast out here in the deep water. Because if I have to wait out, I need to fish where I'm waiting out. So I don't scare fish. And this one took, like 10 meters in front of me. So I could easily have scared it. Now it wouldn't have mattered because this is a small one, but it could have been a 60, 70 plus centimeter. You never know. Big fish also is really close to the shoreline.
Brilliant.
So, but I think we would call this is the category don't count. It's under 30 centimeter. So let's put it back into its place.
Yeah.
Bye-bye. And it's out there.
Okay.
Perfect. So that was a start, and now we take the mother.
Yeah.
What a sweet little sea trout for you, Lasse. Well done. But remember that all the fish have to be minimum 30 centimeters to count in the competition. But when there is small fish around, there can be big ones as well. Several hours within the competition, none of the teams have caught a fish that counts. So both teams are still stuck with the same amount of points they had left after the morning. And as this wasn't bad enough, Søren and Erik is now facing a new problem.
Don't lose it!
Fuck sake, that was a lure. Erik, did you tie this knot?
Watch where it broke.
Yeah, I'm gonna pick up my lure.
Yeah, you better do that. If a team member loses a lure, they don't get a replacement unless they buy one. So you better find that lure. This could be important at the end of the day.
A little bit further out.
But it's quite deep out there, you know?
Yeah.
Oh, that's why you're in here. Okay, okay, makes sense. But the whole thing is that we cannot really afford to lose a lure, so maybe I have to go diving for this one.
A little bit more, maybe? Yeah, it could, yeah. No, really?
We, at least we have one spare lure, two spare lures.
Yeah, that's enough. So, a few more knots.
I mean, it was you who tied my knot, right?
You cannot blame me.
Believe me, I will.
That didn't end very well for Søren and Eric, who lost the lure. Luckily, they bought four lures in the morning, so they have now three lures left until they are forced to buy some new ones. Meanwhile, at another place on Fynen, it finally seems like Lasse and Matze has found some fish.
Okay, I just saw a very nice 50 plus centimeter fish jump out of the water right here. While I moved down to this stretch. As I mentioned before, you have to keep an eye on the surface at all times. If I didn't pay attention there, I would never have seen that fish. Ay, he lost it! Fuck! Yeah. Sorry, I can't swear on TV.
I think I have to change my lure.
I think you should go with a sand deal as well, Matze. Right now, it seems like they are in on Tobis. Yeah, got it. Ah, it's a small one.
Den er tæt på 30, den der.
Should we measure it?
No, it's not. It's
in the late 20s.
The late 20s.
Yeah. So, I saw a 50 plus centimeter fish jump free of the water. And I said, fish right here, we need to get that fish. And I had actually a really hard strike after the first two, three casts. And then I get this one. So again, it just proves that bigger fish also is in the same area with the small ones. So it just, even though you get some small ones, just keep hammering, because we know there's big fish in a stretch like this. So now we go for bigger.
Yeah.
Now we're enough with the warm-up.
Finally.
It's a bit of a struggle here because, you know, we can find another spot, like right now, and just go leave this. Oh, fish? No.
No.
Oh, my heart. Or we could just give ourselves the time to fish this spot, you know, and find the fish.
Always,
I mean, it's always a struggle.
Yeah, always the same.
What do you think?
I think we have to leave.
Yeah, leave?
Yeah.
Like right now?
Let's go.
Okay, so that was kind of a boomer.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it feels so bad to not catch anything, and we lost the lure.
Yeah.
So,
we lost, already.
And we lost time. Yeah, for sure. At least we still got some time. We have not even fished half of the day yet.
Yeah.
And everything can happen. I mean, we can go for hours not catching anything, and then suddenly, bam.
And the best time in the evening is still in front of us. Need a few more clouds, maybe, and a little bit more windy conditions. A little bit
more current.
Yeah.
A little bit more sea trout.
And then we will fish the fish.
Our asses off now.
Yeah.
Like really, we gotta find the fish.
Yeah.
Okay. New spot, no waves.
No.
Christ. Yeah, so we moved up here to find some current and some waves. And as you can see,
nothing.
No waves. Should we give it like 20 minutes?
Yeah, 20 minutes.
But we can still see some darker patches out there. And it seems like there's a bit deeper water here.
Yeah. So you start with the Sørling.
I start with the Sørling.
Yeah, and also again with the sand eel.
Yeah. Nice.
Perfect.
Cool, let's do this, mate.
Let's go.
For Team Sun and Eric, it just seems like it's not their day today. At least not yet. Time is running. The two teams have now used half of the fishing time of the first day. Still no point fish for none of them, but now, something is happening with Lasse and Matze. Maybe it's a point fish.
I'm coming.
Ah, it's the same size.
Is it? Ah, it's 30.
Yeah.
So we just landed our fourth fish, and it's actually the same size of the others, but we are a little bit curious about, is it 30 or is it in the late 20s? So now we just, to be sure, we will measure them. Yeah, it's actually 31 centimeter, let's say 30.5, so it's a 30 centimeter fish. Then we haven't said anything wrong.
Okay.
So, bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Yeah, great.
Yes.
So four fish, the first ones, we actually thought they were under 30, but so we actually got four fish over 30 now.
That's,
or just, but if,
it's fine.
It doesn't matter. It was our mistake not to measure them. But we have the first fish now.
Hope for bigger ones.
Yes.
Yeah.
But okay, the other team need a chance. I mean,
we are
the better fishermen on the upper hand, so.
Well, well, well. There goes the first points in the competition. Not a big one, but at least some points. Now, Mats and Lasse raises their points from 110 points to 115 points and take the lead by inches. Back at Sun and Eric, there is still no fish to be found despite their great efforts. Come on guys, you can do this.
So we talked a bit about making a new tactic now, because we don't catch anything. Surprise, surprise. So nothing new to report from here. But I have quite a smaller lure than Eric has, and out here we have like a really big dark path. So yeah, Eric can try to reach that one, and then I think I'll jump in front with the smaller lure and try to fish the weed line in here, because we have a lot of vegetation in here alongside the shoreline, and maybe with the small lure dragged across the weed line could do the trick. I don't know, could do the trick.
Yeah, the special thing on this spot is it's like an edge on the coastline. It goes quick, and today the wind blows from the right and very hard and produces some current in this place. On the left side it's more calm, and I think it's a place that can hold some fish. There's some fish, not in the last 30 minutes, but it's a nice place.
It seems like both teams is stuck, not catching any fish. The scoreboard seems stuck as well, as it hasn't changed for a while. Maybe the teams would be better off going for a swim just to cool them down. The first day of the competition is now halfway over, and we now allow the teams to call each other.
Hello guys.
Hey guys, what's up?
Hi.
Fishing team one here.
Fishing team one, oh my god. What's up, how's the fishing been?
It's not good, it's not bad, it's all right.
Yeah, it's all right.
Okay.
How about you?
It's not good, it's bad. I would say we have found some fish, but they were not that active.
We have the same problem as well. Let's just say the bigger fish weren't that active.
Okay, so they caught them.
We got some numbers.
So you're going for the number. So where are you guys fishing? Like, not the exact spot, of course, but...
The southeast of Fynen.
Do you have any current or any waves or anything where you're fishing?
We have a lot of waves.
A lot of waves.
Yeah, we have a lot of waves here as well, but we are in the northeastern part of Fynen.
Northeast?
Yeah.
How much is northeast?
It's northeast, then you can. Guys, we're gonna go fishing now. We have a lot of fish to catch.
Yeah, definitely.
And yeah, tight lines out there. I'll see you later.
Good luck.
I'll see you. Good luck.
See you.
Bye bye.
Bye bye.
They have waves.
And
they
fish.
Have current and fish.
Oh, yeah.
They didn't say how many fish, but I think they got some numbers.
Pretty sure they have
even
more.
Even though it's tiny fish, you know, over 30. It could, it's points.
We have to find waves if we can't catch anything here.
Yeah.
We have to try something completely different.
Yeah. Let's do this.
That's an okay report. It seems like they have a harder fishing time than us. So what's the plan now? Are we going for bigger fish? Are we going for numbers? Should we just hammer some points? Or then we have to go to the small bay areas. But they have to be over 30. They have to be over 70 actually. Numbers, we're going for numbers in 70s. That's the plan.
Oh yes, time to move on. At least it seems like both teams still have their good mood, and it surely seems like they haven't lost faith yet. Now, both teams is moving on, trying to find brand new hunting grounds.
Nice.
It looks good. I mean, you can definitely see the current.
Yeah, new spot, different spot.
New spot, new fish.
Hopefully, and you
fish. Things gotta start happening now for us. This is more like a bit more rough conditions. You can actually see the current is just pushing down here, like alongside. And I think if we just fish that way, down there, I can almost smell the big fish. Yeah.
One big fish, it's enough, maybe.
Yeah. If you catch the 80, then it's. Let's get ready.
Okay. Yo, yo. Garfish. I think it's a garfish.
Don't say that.
Yeah, it's a garfish.
It's a trout?
Yeah, it's a
garfish. It could be a trout.
No!
Believe
me.
Well, Eric, that's not the fish we are targeting today. But garfish often prefers the same conditions as the sea trout and are often to be found in the same places. This is gonna be confirmed moments later when something big is sneaking up on Eric's lure.
Oh, no, big sea trout. Yeah, it was a really good one, a 50. No, but yeah, directly through the over the stones. Oh fuck! But I think she saw me. No.
Was it big?
Yeah, 50, around 50 centimeters. And really, really fat.
Yeah, so the fish are here. Definitely.
The fish was until here, and then it was went away.
Yeah, it must have seen you or something.
Yeah, that's a good sign. Maybe we will find some more.
So Eric just had a follower all the way in. He's still using the 15 gram sand eel, which is a bit slightly bigger lure than the ones I'm using. We have a lot of current out here, so I actually think I'm gonna change to the only lure we have left since I lost the other one. And that's the 16 gram sterling in the motor oil color. So yeah, gonna skip the 12 gram and go for the 16 gram to get a little bit further down in the water. Yeah, there's fish here, definitely. Oh, there's one fish here, but it's not a lure. Hopefully not. Gonna change.
I just want to fish as much water as I can, really fast. So I will just make like 10 casts here, then I will move 30 meters, 10 casts, 30 meters. Just search new waters all the time. But as of now, there's a lot of seaweed in the water here. But maybe I should swap to a single hook if it's keep being annoying. Not the biggest one, around 20. Oh, it's a really small fish, but beautiful. And come again in 2 years or 3 years. That feels good. New place, 10 casts and the first fish. Promising.
It's 30. It's points. I don't have to measure this one. This is actually 30. It's close to 40 actually. Yeah, it's close to 40. It's not 40. It's around 38, I think.
Yeah.
I don't want to measure it. I just think we should release it quick.
Yeah.
But does the cameraman approve that this is over 30?
It is.
We swapped to the single hooks to prevent all the seaweeds, and it worked out. Before we had every single cast, now it's like we can fish a lot more. It's like every third or fourth now. So let's release this one quick. It's actually close to 40, but off you go. Perfect. Yeah. We are on track here.
Finally, one more point fish. Even though it's the biggest of the day, it only counts for 5 points. Still, it's enough to take the lead with a total of 120 points for Matze and Lasse and only 110 points for Søren and Erik. Speaking of these two guys, let's see what's going on.
It's just funny because we're fishing this new area and it's just we keep getting those strikes on the lures. It's like every 5 minutes we get a douche. And we know there is garfish out here. Eric caught one, so some of them can be garfish for sure, but the follower Eric had, it was a nice, nice, nice fish.
Oh, yep.
Yeah. And Eric is on that. That's a trout, right?
Yeah, I hope so.
It's going deep out there. It's not in the surface.
Oh, yo, maybe.
Way to go, Eric. Nice job, man. Just don't lose. Oh.
Not
just
that bad.
Don't lose it.
It's a garfish, no. Just joking.
It's a trout, right?
Yeah.
It is a damn trout.
I hope.
Not a bad trout, mate. It's not a bad trout.
It's a fighter. Oh no, it's a...
It's a garfish? I think I saw it.
Oh god, god.
It must be trout. Right?
It's a trout, I think.
Yeah, I saw a silver... No.
No, oh god.
It's a garfish. No, it's trout. It's trout. It's trout.
It's a mackerel! Oh god! Oh Jesus! Oh fuck!
Oh, well, that's a nice trout, right?
Yeah. Oh man.
But it's a nice mackerel though.
Yeah.
Nice one. It's not a trout, but it's damn pretty. But I was sure that was a trout.
Next one. Oh man.
But yeah, we have garfish.
Yeah.
We have small trout. We have a mackerel. The next one is gonna be a giant trout.
Come on.
Oh. Wait a minute. I thought this was Sea Trout Smash. Unfortunately, the garfish and mackerel doesn't give any points, so you guys better search for some nice sea trout instead. Let's leave the mackerel guys and head back to Lasse and Matze.
Now we just got a little bit further up on the stretch here, and we are not experiencing much seaweed anymore. So we actually both swapped back to triple hooks again. I've swapped lure to the Seeger just to try to irritate some fish. Maybe it's what they want now, some more shiny colors. Mats keeps on going with the serling. It's yep. been very good here.
Two fish, some strikes, and
yeah, exactly. We still need the bigger ones.
Finally.
Yes. But we got a point here.
Okay.
We got points here.
Yeah.
Nice.
Have you seen it?
I actually had a small strike as well.
A long spin stop. Maybe 3-4 seconds. Yeah, don't know. Okay, this is a point fish. Maybe. Point fish. 32?
It's 31.
Points!
3 points.
Okay, fast release. It's another point.
Yeah.
5 points.
Yeah!
Better one! I think it's a better one.
It is.
Slow.
Are we over 40?
Moving slow. And,
That's cool. Is that 30? I think it's 30. The serling is really doing the job right now. It is 30. Yeah. No questions asked here. Can you hold the net just like that?
I can.
Yep. You see?
Yeah.
It's 31.
31 yeah. Again.
So, does cameraman approve?
Yeah.
Yep. Okay. Let us win. We're actually getting some points now. Yeah.
You are absolutely right, Lasse. The points just keep coming. Well done, boys. Even though these fish aren't the biggest ones, you have managed to climb up to a 130 points in total and is now way ahead of the other team. Let's head back to Eric and Søren and see if the Sea Trout wanna play.
Where are you? I don't know what this is, mate. Oh, it's a mackerel. Yeah, it's a mackerel. Damn. But at least it's a fish. But it's just so funny because they just fight so well.
Yeah.
Not the trap we came for, but off he goes.
Yeah,
nope. Nice.
Mackerel.
Yep.
Okay.
Fish.
What?
Why are we catching mackerels? It should be trout. But it's just, they're just taking line like there's no tomorrow. Are you stuck in me or something? It's fucking heavy. Maybe we should move a bit, even though it's fun, this fishing. If it's only mackerel and not trout. But it's just so fun. Guys, just look at the size of this one.
Okay. Enough of the mackerels. If just these small strong fighters gave any points, you guys would have taken the lead for sure. With only 1 hour left of today's fishing, let's jump over to Lasse and Matze, where the sea trout is still active.
We had two strikes, 1 minute, two strikes. And Lasse got a strike in this channel, in this deep channel, between the shore and the first reef, the sand reef. Seems to be quite effective to fish the serling quite slow and a kind of jigging. Like this, nearly every cast I have a strike or a fish on. It's crazy.
So what's happening right now is that the serling outfishes everything right here on this stretch. So we decided to open for the candy shop here. I'm actually gonna fire a serling. Yeah, we have 16 grams. I'm gonna stick with that then. I'm taking the red and black here. I like this color this time of year. So. I think it's going to be the red and black. So it will cost us 30 points instead of 20 because we are buying it out here on the water. So that's it. 30 points used for our team.
As Lasse mentioned, buying a lure at the water costs 30 points. That's actually all the points the team has earned today. Suddenly the scoreboard looks different as Lasse and Matze now only have 100 points left. This puts Eric and Søren in the lead with 110 points. Was this a good idea? Just a few moments later, we're about to find out.
And now we got a good fish. This is really interesting now because now we actually got a big fish. Oh. Yeah, this is something. Right now it's just following. I have to see this fish. I really need to see this fish. Just need to put tight line all the time. We have a lot of weeds here. We don't want to get stuck. It's a good fish. It's a really big fish, actually. I don't think it's hooked that well. It's a good fish. It's a really good fish, Batsy. You need to be quick.
Huh?
You need to be quick.
Cool. Yes! That's what we need. Exactly what we need. I could just see the hook. It was about to get loose. You can see it right there. I will measure it really quick here. Even though it's a really great fish, we still need to take care of them the best way.
It's what? 55?
Oh, it's 56 actually.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's 56 centimeter. Yes. 56 centimeter.
Yeah.
Does the cameraman approve? 56?
Yeah, I think
nice.
So.
Nice. Nice. We got it.
Man. Okay.
Wow. What a fish to end the first day of the competition. A stunning 56 centimeter sea trout makes up for an extra 20 points for Lasse and Madsen. They now take the lead once again, ending the first day with a 120 points in total. Great job, boys. The first day of the competition is over and we clearly have one team in front with a lot of fish today and many contests. For the other team, well, better luck tomorrow. This was the end of the first episode of Sea Trout Smash Season 1. Thank you so much for watching. Remember to subscribe to our channel and stay tuned for episode 2 next week.